He must say yes. Make him say yes.
For a glimpse of the sky, this ain't no time to breathe. Hello.
Hello.
Good and good and a morning.
Good and a morning. Surprise, mother fathers. We're on time. What do you know?
Indeed.
Once in a blue moon, it happens. This is mostly thanks to Mike getting me up this morning.
I was a secret to it.
What is it?
I didn't know.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
Mike, what?
I'm really awake.
I was wondering why the bed wasn't out. You haven't slept?
No.
What? Why not,
here,
you
Mike.
Bonkers?
We need your help. Even though literally every time we talk to you, you double-cross us, kidnap us, or threaten to destroy everything we love.
Maybe we are here for a fight.
God.
Hello, Porky.
Porky!
I'm just grabbing your submission.
I'm just interrogating Mike and why he hasn't slept.
I've been awake.
Why? Why? What have you been doing?
Work.
What do you mean? What work?
I was working. Well, because I was feeling ill earlier, and then I had the caffeine, then I'm a little bit wired, and I have felt sleepy, and I just kept working.
What were you working on?
Mystic.
Oh, that's great. I mean, it's not great that you sacrificed your sleep for it, though.
I know, but, like...
If you're feeling awake, then at least, like, when you get tired later, you can crash and have a nap and everything.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah. Maybe we are here for a fight!
I was in and out of Porky's stream while they were working.
Hey! Nice job, Porky. How are you doing?
I kinda said that we could maybe do Porky's mission first. He could go sleep. So.
Oh, that's that's totally fair.
If you're up for that, Porky, I can make that happen.
He has the power.
Yeah. Executive orders. Okay, they're uploading.
Awesome.
There's three extra ones now.
Three extra ones?
Yeah.
Three?
I think, anyway.
For a total of 10.
Total of 10.
You guys came out this week.
The submission thing form is now closed.
The submission form is now closed.
Right, now I have to find the form.
Quick, everyone, upload another!
No, don't upload another. No. Gone.
How was everyone's weekend? Anywho. How are you all?
Okay, I can see the chat again.
Good.
Here we are. Another mad thing. Cool. Okay. Hello. My pants are shiny.
Another mad thing.
Have you got Sync SketchUp? You got NDI on?
No.
Do both of those things.
Okay, NDI should now be on. Whoop, 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 whoop.
There we go. Okay. That said, you might need to press. Okay.
He got in all the last frames of the fourth character. Fourth character? Fourth character? Porky, what have you been up to? Okay, so which one is Porky's at the end here? This.
That.
Okay. Yeah, it's got his little sign up at the top. I keep forgetting to remind people to do that. But yeah, stick your details on it. Oh. Yes.
Being triggered by the Animorian challenge.
Michael!
What?
Michael!
I tell people to put it in the top left. There's a template and everything.
What? There's a template for putting your social media stuff on?
Yeah.
Where? Is there? Indie Swift, who's never looked at the submission form before.
There.
Oh, I see. Can you just, like, move it a little bit for this? It's no hair off your back, mate. Yeah. I was like, there's a template? I know, right? I didn't know either.
I mean, there's an image. It's like, put your social...
Didn't know it was like you if you don't, then the world's going to explode.
It's no trouble really. I'm just like, oh, he's playing on the top right. I'm like, is it behind the thing? Because I can't see it. I'm looking at the mission through OBS.
I see.
Let's not make a big thing of it.
I'm not trying to. Okay, I guess we'll just go for it. I don't want to keep Porky waiting. Because it must be super late for people who are in Amurica.
Only like half.
Is it?
Yeah.
But, oh no.
He was streaming for 9 hours. And
9 hours?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, he needs... Porky, you need rest. Let's have a look.
Okay.
All together. Here we go. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, what the... This is so cool! Heck yeah! Oh no! Oh, nice reference!
It's a good way to include it. That's really cool, Porky.
Yeah, I want to watch it again with the reference in mind now.
You know what? For future submissions, if you have used reference and stuff, I think it'd be really cool to include it like this, because then we get to see like where your influences are, and we can also see what you're aiming toward as well.
So cool. You get to see where the characters on twos and the background on ones. That looks so nice. Oh. This is so cool, Porky.
I was about to say, maybe not. Yeah.
I mean, it is. There's a reason Porky used that reference, because it's awesome. I love how you're playing with the depth from background to foreground here. Having characters overlap things and go behind other things is so fun. Having this little droid thing kind of swoop close to the camera is so nice. And it feels super energetic as well, because there's so much stuff going on all at once. Didn't expect you to do like 4 whole characters, Porky. This is amazing. I love the way that they're interacting with the background as well. That's so fun. What does the little dude at the background do? I also really like this character that you're using. Like this reoccurring character of the girl.
I think the robots are reoccurring.
Yeah, I think this entire set of characters is something that Porky uses sometimes for the challenges, and I'm into it. Like, they're so cool. Yeah. Nice shortcut.
Nothing eludes Swifty.
Yeah, well, I mean...
Especially when she can frame by frame.
Yeah, I'm not going to critique you on that, because I know that if you had the time, you would have like animated that properly. You don't need me to tell you.
Yeah, I was in his stream, and he was like, okay, I've got 2 hours to go, and I'm like, no, you don't. You got this minute. Yeah.
There's something in the run of the girl. I think that's where I'm going to aim my critique, because all these, I feel like these little dudes are working super well. I really like the bouncy run here. That's so fun. I like the way you're varying the runs up. So the run here is different to the run here, where because they've just fallen down, they've got a bit more spring in their step because they're carrying that forward momentum of being tossed off their feet a little bit. That's really fun. Also, like, really nice job maintaining the volume of these things as they go toward and away from cam.
Also, it's really clever to have the flying. It's swooping close when it's doing that, but keeps your eye in that set, like the composition really keeps your eye there, so you can appreciate as doing that tumble. There's not that much spin either. There's not a lot of track. You're like guiding the audience to see where they need to. Oh, I'm cutting off. Jeez. Okay, I'm right next to my microphone.
I think maybe you just need to adjust the gate.
Okay, let me...
Like, make your gate way lower. while Mike does that, I'm going to call something else out, which is just that it does a really nice feeling of texture. I think going off what Mike was saying, having this flying character swoop close to the camera in a very smooth arc and all its movements be very smooth, and then the tip, 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 tip of these running boxes, they offset one another really nicely because we have nice smooth movement and we have kind of more staccato beats in there as well. So there's a lot of texture to the timing. I think the box here, when it trips up, comes out of that trip larger than it went in. But it quickly goes back to...
I just want to test, is this better for you guys? It looks better. It looks like I can sort of talk across the microphone and it's still picking me up.
Good.
Cool. I think I heightened the gate because of India's tendency to yell.
Because of my tendency to yell? Excuse me! Just for these couple of frames. It's back to its usual size here. I see. So yeah, you were saying, Mike, what, do you want to go over your point again?
I was just saying it was really cool to see how Porky was constructing the shot and leading the audience to view where he needed them to, like
guiding the eye.
There's not a lot of movement on, like you see previously in the shot, the robot spins and does a whole bunch of cool stuff, but when the focus is meant to be on that little dude that you're finding with the red, it has a slightly more kind of gradual, nice, smooth curve, which is leading you to like look at where he's going to be doing the tumble and the land. But all of the motion, all of the kind of texture is on the robot at that point. It's just a really nice way that you're not having everything happen all at once, even though they're all constantly moving. You have this kind of varying shift between like more active and more passive. And that's really important to learn when you have multiple characters in the scene, is you don't want them to all be like high texture at the same time, because you won't know where to look.
Yeah, that's true. You don't want all these characters all doing their stuff. You want the audience to be looking at all at the same time, because you won't know where your eye is meant to go on screen. It's nice that this one in the background is just doing a little run forward. And yeah, the overlap in this too is really nice. Like all the little box flappies and the hands coming out of the boxes and everything. Really nice overlap. This must have taken so long to do and been so intensive as well. Like you make it look simple with the movement on this little robot. I'm going to call it a flying robot because I'm not sure what else to call it.
Maybe you've got names for us.
But getting that nice smooth movement on there and having those trails animating every frame. Like, that's time consuming stuff. Super awesome. It might be nice to have it start turning a little bit sooner. As it swoops over this way. It's probably because you were pasting the frame. Which is totally fair because, like I said, it's pretty intensive. But it might have been nice to have it just start turning over this way as it's drifting backwards. Up to you, though.
Let's see. I'm going to see whether Porky wrote anything in the... If Porky had time to write anything in the
Yeah, I'd be surprised if Porky had time to do anything.
I ran out of time to answer this.
Yeah, fair. No judgment, Porky.
There is a little bit. I'm just waiting for my computer to load it.
Okay.
Wow. It's working. Oh, there we go. Also, timing everything to happen at the right time due to the panning background was silly hard.
Yeah. Yeah, like, you make it look easy, Porky, if it makes you feel any better. Like, you make it look very natural and easy, but I know it can't have been. Like, holy guacamole. Okay, so I'm just looking at the female run here, and I think this character running is the thing that I would pinpoint a critique on, because all the little dudes feel like they're working so well, you know. There's a missed frame of one here, and that's like the only thing. It's like, it's nothing to do with the animation. The animation's awesome. I think for her, there's something where it just feels like she maybe isn't running as fast as the background's moving. There's like a disconnect there. And I'm trying to figure out what it is, and I think it might be the poses less than the actual foot position itself. Let me see. I love this bit where she trips over, because I never expect it. Yeah, the foot position is really difficult to track. I can see that you're using landmarks on the background to keep foot in the right position, so it should be right. Maybe it's here in this stumble as well. There's a little bit of a cheat happening. Like, it feels like she should, if she's slamming that foot down, that back foot down, it should probably be a little further along on the ground, this, because she's kind of catching herself from falling almost with the stumble, right?
Orky asks, do you think it's missing frames?
On the run?
I'm not sure. Whatever you were talking about. I zoomed out.
I don't feel like it's missing frames on the run, to be honest. Let me just have a look at the run again. No, I think it's okay. I think the problem that I'm feeling is that the positions don't feel extreme enough. Based on the reference as well, if this is the feeling that you're going for, I love this. Look at that amazing line of action.
So she feels like she's doing more of a jog.
Yeah.
But the speed of the footage implies that she should be more running. Is that what you're seeing?
Yeah, although I'm still battling with my feelings that maybe she's not keeping pace with the footage, but she is, because I'm looking at her foot placement, and her foot placement is matching the footage. So this little bit here,
she is like,
it feels like she should maybe be a little bit further along here if she's slammed her foot down. So I'm looking at this little bit of the background here.
That's what I was gonna say. Porgy's saying, I was thinking of how to do it as a not intense version of it, because she's running too, but not quite fast enough to keep up with the camera. So it's intentionally less intense of a run.
Okay. Let me just read that in the chat again.
Also, if you like what you're seeing here and you want to see more of Porky's animation, you can find his Twitter over here.
Feels like foot from stumble, or like the body in general. You could probably just move this frame forward a little bit, because if she's slamming the foot down, it implies she's catching herself and stopping herself from falling. Which it makes sense to me would be like a step more forward in a less controlled way. Should be catching her.
trying to think of all the ways that a trip and a fall can occur. There's like, if you've ever stood on your lace and tried to lift your foot, there's a point where you can't move your foot as far as you expect. Mm-hmm. And so you have to like throw out your leg in a way that you weren't expecting. There's something blocking your foot, so you trip that's when you trip over something. So your foot hits and it can't go the full way to catch yourself. There is your foot lands on a surface that you don't have the traction that you were expecting, and so it slides forward, back, left or right. Which like ruins your gait. And then is there any other ways you can think of?
When you just stumble over your feet.
When you kick your own foot.
You know, when you're super tired and your legs aren't functioning as you want them to be. Mm. Or you're distracted by something.
Yeah.
So yeah, when it comes to this run and doing a less intense version of it, I think you're pretty successful in that. But there's some feet positions here that I feel like you need to maintain to make it feel like a run. So the contact position with the leg slightly bent, I would straighten that leg out. And also one of the things about a run that makes it a run, the difference between a run and a walk is a run, you have both legs off the... Sorry, both feet off the floor at the same time. Whereas with a walk, your feet never leave the floor. And with this run, there's not any air time to it. Which makes it feel weirdly like a walk, even though it's a run.
Ah, so that's the missing frame then.
Potentially. Although, look at this Ghibli one. There's not really air time here. I think maybe because the positions are so energetic, you're still getting that feeling. So maybe we can do a similar thing here.
I think you could potentially say that the lifted knee is your like air time.
Yeah. Like the lifted knee in the Ghibli one would fall here.
Yeah.
You would have this kind of position. Look at this amazing drawing, guys. Incredible. Just incredible.
Short hands are good.
Yeah. So, let me show you what I mean. So, the leg doesn't feel like it's stretching far enough forward for the run to feel like a run. So, let me show ye. So, even if we're having a less extreme version of the Ghibli run, there's still certain things that we need. And a straight leg on the contact, I think, is one of them.
I'm trying to say enjoy your work, Martin.
And then we're getting this nice curve going through the back here. And you kind of want that to follow up into the neck as well.
Yeah, I tried to say walk and it came out work. So it came out world.
Enjoy your work! Walk sounds amazing, seriously.
Yeah, I said that. That sounds like a good morning routine.
Can I make this drawing hold? Actually, I might not want it to, because it needs to shift with the camera. So we have that, and then on the position here, the passing position, because it's directly after your contact, it's also serving as your weight. So you want the leg to be more bent here. That it's really taking the weight of the run.
I think also there's a kind of an odd tangent thing happening with like one leg being pressed so close up to the other. I think I would want more overlap there to show the form moving across. If you've only got that frame to do it, I would maybe just nudge that front leg just a little bit more. Yeah. Just a clearer silhouette.
Yeah, I think as well, really connecting the neck to that back.
No way! I can't believe this!
Just believe it, Robotnik.
I can't believe.
Wait, what? 10 months? Oh my goodness. The time has flown faster than any bird I have ever photographed, yet it also feels like it has been years since the night I was there and you guys reached affiliate. Y'all rock. It's been a great ride.
Aw, Sam Rainier, thank you so much.
Thank you.
It's been so cool to have you here with us while we've been doing it. Thank you so much for all the support. It means a huge deal. And yeah, 10 months. What the heck, right? Where's the time gone?
Into many projects, many things, many, many things. Although, if I could summarize 2020, it's been... COVID Mystic Rise.
COVID Mystic Rise.
Yep. That's been 2020 for me.
So the head here feels like disconnected from the back.
And Twitch. There's a poor thing. Twitch. Of course.
Of course. Sorry if I'm not like picking up your conversation threads. It's because I'm...
It's your focus.
I'm thinking about what to say about this as I'm doodling. So I'm sorry if I'm leaving you hanging on some things.
I'm leaving you hanging on pretty.
So make sure the neck is connected to the rest of pose. By which I mean, I favor the shorthand of just joining the neck onto the back line. Like, I think that's a nice elegant way to do it, but it's not necessarily on style with what you might want to do. Like, it's not very anime to do that. It's more kind of Disney Western to do that. So, you know, it works for some people, not for others, but either way, I think with this really nice straight line you have for the back here and the direction you've got the back going in, you want the neck to kind of follow along with that and hook into that so it doesn't feel too separated from the rest of the pose. It's going to push your head forward as well, so your head's going to end up being on this line pretty much.
Like this.
And then we have the push off here.
I mean, with the addition of the lean there of the head, it makes me realize that running is just moving your feet quick enough that you don't hit your face on the floor.
Yeah, it's falling with style, man. It's catching yourself. That's what walking is too. That's why we lean forward. If we didn't have our feet to catch us, we would face plant. And the faster we go, the more we lean forward.
Part of running is gravity, like, or you know,
letting gravity do its thing.
You know, like gravity go down, catch with foot, push up, push forward.
So I'd be tempted to again just simplify this line of action, bring it right the way down the leg.
Have you ever tried running while leaning backward?
Yeah.
Is it possible?
Yeah, it is. It's very funny and cartoony. Think of Monty Python. Or Jack Sparrow trying to get away from something.
Okay, yeah.
Ministry of Silly Walks. Like, I used to do that shit all the time because I used to mostly move like a cartoon character because it was fun.
But just day to day.
Yeah, if I was ever trying to get away with something, I would run away like a cartoon character. You know, and people would have to deal with it.
What were you trying to get away with?
I don't know, like, whatever mischief I'd been up to.
Were you a mischievous child?
A pretty, yeah. Me and my pals were pretty mischievous.
D-Sloog's in the chat.
Yo, D-Sloog's! What? I don't know, dude. That's your horn fanfare. How's it going? How are you? How's it going? What was I doing? Ah, yes. This. I was lifting this up just a little bit. Just making this position a little bit more extreme. Unfolding that leg a little bit slower. I'm just checking it with the rest of the poses to see that it makes sense. Like, you might be able to get some airtime here, actually. I wonder. This is betraying the Ghibli reference that you were looking at. Well, what if?
Okay, I will say that you have...
Oh, no, Michael!
One more piece of advice that you can give.
But Michael, I'm not done.
Pick it wisely.
If we assume this frame happens actually just after where you currently have it, so the foot's just picked up off the floor, we can get a little bit of airtime in there. And I'm sorry for my chicken scratch drawings. This is just how I sketch. I'm not the cleanest sketcher. And then here you'd want, again, that leg to be stretched out. Just straighten it, essentially. I wish that I could repeat this so you could see it in motion properly rather than see it cycle one time.
Can you copy frames on Sync Sketch?
Not as far as I know.
Although it wouldn't match up.
Yeah, you'd need to.
You're right, my friend!
Yeah.
Sorry, I've missed so many streams.
You should be.
No, you shouldn't.
Where have you been?
You have your own life. Don't worry about it. It's cool. We're here like every morning. We're not going anywhere.
Thank you very much for the bits. How are you doing? John Animate.
There we go.
You better have been animating if you weren't here.
All right. So I wish you could just... Wait, maybe we can. Oh no, that's skip for it. I was like, wait, no, wait, maybe we can. In point?
Oh, out point? Day. Out point?
Hey, Odsuren, how's it going? Yeah, I can play just a short amount of it. And maybe that'll help us see the... It doesn't help us see the animation, but maybe... Maybe it's better than me just playing it and then stopping it, than playing it and stopping it. Yeah. Go to frame. No, don't do that. Just do as I bid you. Okay, let me just very quickly get the feet positions in. So it's a bit easier to see.
You're almost time up.
No.
Gotta move on to the next person.
I can't.
Porky's already a great animator, isn't he anymore?
Porky is already a fantastic animator.
Yeah, so just move on.
I learned a lot from looking at Porky's stuff, honestly. Like, this is... Dope. This dope as all heck, man.
I'm being harsh for the comedy.
Harsh with the comedy?
Harsh for the comedy.
For the comedy. For the lols.
Yeah, harsh with the comedy. Lols was sort of a
thing. You always think it's funny to be harsh to me.
I'm sassy when I haven't slept.
You're sassy all the time,
right? I got no time for this.
We do.
But we have to move on.
We do have to move on. But also, we also have time for this.
We have time for Porky, but we don't have time to give him
I wonder if we could push this backwards a little bit. Push that. You know, to make it a little bit more like the position that we lost from here. We could push that leg a little bit farther back. Maybe.
We didn't start early, Hinkapink. We started on time.
Yeah.
This is
what it's meant to be. This is when we promised our streams would be 2 hours earlier than they actually are. What do you know? I actually got off on time today. Thanks to Mike. What?
I was just going to talk about my caffeine withdrawal.
You can talk about it.
Okay. I experienced caffeine withdrawal yesterday because I hadn't had any Coke. And the reason I hadn't had any Coke is because I haven't been drinking Coke. And the reason that I hadn't been drinking Coke is I don't really have caffeine, except in the last week, I got more caffeine than for a long time. Because I got like a 1.5 liter bottle and drank that in one day. And then a couple of other days surrounding that, I was having like maybe a liter here, a liter there. And then I went without it for a couple of days. So yesterday it was like, oh man, I have a headache and I feel a bit nauseous. And I usually get that when I've had cheese or I've got like lactose intolerance. And so I'm like, oh, it's just that. So I know what this is. But then it wasn't that, because it didn't, I threw up when that occurs, and I threw up, and then afterwards I was like, I still feel awful. Went to nap, felt a little better, came back up, had a headache. And ended up ordering food because I was hungry, and with the food I was like, oh, I'll get a Coke, because that's what I get when I get like takeout from that place. And I had the Coke, and I'm like, I feel better now.
Wait.
And then I searched what the symptoms of caffeine withdrawal were, because I haven't ever experienced it before, to my knowledge. And yeah, it matched up. So in a week, I simultaneously gave myself a caffeine dependency and a withdrawal.
Nice job, Mike.
Thanks.
You know, and they say that you don't accomplish anything. They've never said that.
Thank you for...
multitasking.
Yeah. Okay, we're moving on to the next submission.
Okay. I just wanted to say that after looking at your playing, I think I might push the head forward too much. So... Porky, if you want to take any of the notes I've given you here, which you don't have to because you are like already animating at a super high level, like this is all subjective, then I'd say to kind of maintain the less extreme posture you have for her in terms of the running, just push my head slightly backwards that I've drawn on here. You know, so you have like a kind of S curve happening on the back rather than it going straight through like an arrow. Of your own life.
Take control, yeah.
Nice. Take control of your own life. But yeah, this is the heating's on. It should be. We have it on timed now, right?
Yeah.
So these are the notes I have for the legs. In terms of just really making sure that you straighten out, make sure you straighten out the leg on the contact, and if you can get a frame in the air, I think that will help the feeling of it. As it is, I think the problem is just that it doesn't feel like the feet are traveling far enough for it to really be a run. It feels more like kind of a power stride. Let me... put the out point a little bit further along.
Yeah, good job, Porky.
Yeah, amazing job as always. Let me just have a look at the stumble, because that's like the kind of more intensive part.
It coincides with the robot jettisoning out and off. You could almost see that it's like, boom, it's like, wow. Can you run it start to finish when you're done?
Yeah, sure thing. Yeah, like I think here on this frame it might be nice to have that leg extend backwards a little bit. Let me just take these off. Yeah, aye.
There yeah, we're doing Anna Morning Challenges again. Tally friends.
Tally friends! Just because I'm watching this and I kind of want it to kick up, you know, a little bit to follow that uncontrollable feeling through a little bit. Yeah, and then I think the rest of it is working nicely. It goes back into the run. If you want her to feel like a good way to make it feel unbalanced is to throw that center line off a little bit, so you would have her legs stretched like further back than her torso, so she eventually unbalances, if that makes sense. So you want this frame of contact here to feel like she's overshooting her legs, if that makes sense. Like, so this is a point where it would make sense to stretch the contact position less far, because in this stumble where she falls here, essentially her torso is still moving forward while his legs are trying to play catch up, and it causes an imbalance. This is actually the frame I was thinking of here with this contact. Like, if you have pushed the legs a little bit further back here. Hey, this is actually Dee Slug's music as well.
It is. Although, my update thingy wouldn't tell you that. It's not running. I wish it wasn't a separate piece of software that I have to remember to run. Or maybe I could make it like a launch file that ran all the things. Ran all the things.
I like this position. This is fun. This trip position you have here, Porky. It's a lot of fun. Yeah, and then I just throw that back leg up. But if you see here, that unbalanced feeling of the torso being ahead of the legs, I think is what's going to make your trip feel more convincing. No, Timbo!
Because she's overbalancing.
Yeah.
Like,
her legs haven't caught her in time because they're behind, essentially. We take this note off here. Just because I intended this for a later frame.
Okay, move on.
Okay, I want to play it all the way through for David.
Cool.
Here you go. So cool. See, I think one of the reasons that these little dudes are working a bit better, particularly the one in the foreground, is because their runs are on a more rapid pace and the positions are a bit more extreme.
There's a little bit more exaggeration. Like, mm-hmm. I think maybe there could be a little bit more up and down on the girl.
Yeah. I think you'll get that from making that weight position a bit more extreme. You'll naturally get that up and down. I think you're thinking along the right line, so making it less extreme than the reference you were looking at. I think you might have taken it slightly too far in that direction, though. I think you want something like in between the two. Amazing work.
Good job.
So cool. Right? D-Sluke says, holy sheet! So awesome. Yeah, like Porkyboy, this like your animation is so fun. I love it so much. So good, dude.
Back.
Incredible work. The falling animation was done in the last 30 minutes. Yeah, I bet. Like, I don't know how you managed to get this all done in time. This is incredible. You definitely spent more than 3 hours on this. Porkyboy, you're totally welcome. Like, it was very hard to find things to feed back on, to be honest, because it's so good. And like I said, take my advice with a pinch of salt, because it's all subjective. I think you did an incredible job.
Who's up next?
Do you want me to ping back to the beginning?
Yeah, okay.
Okay. So this is Zeb's.
Zeb.
Does have sound on it, by the looks of it.
Don't. Oh, it has sound on it.
Yeah, everybody go follow Porky. Everybody go follow everyone who participates in the Anime Morning Challenge.
I know Habbo's has sound on it, so if you need to boot through your NDI audio, let me know.
Oh, okay.
Maybe I'll just do the NDI audio anyway. You're not watching the stream, are you? With audio?
No.
Okay.
Have the stream muted. The Francis guy, is it absolutely appropriate to fill out the forms to do the challenge?
Yes.
I remember not having to. Yeah, it's... You don't necessarily have to fill it out, but you do have to submit via the form. Just because otherwise it's... hard for Mike to gather them up because he has to literally go and either ping people and DM them or search on Twitter for them, whereas if I submitted via the form, he just has them.
I can just download them.
Yeah. So definitely submit via the form, even if you don't end up filling out all the stuff. Speaking of the form, before we look at Zeb's, did Zeb say anything?
Zeb said stuff, yeah.
Oh my gosh, John Animate says, oh, I watched her make this earlier today. She streamed it on YouTube.
Oh, cool.
For anyone who doesn't know, Zeb has a really, really good YouTube channel where she streams her cleanup on Lackadaisy. She also streams games sometimes. And the main function of her channel is like an incredible bank of videos on how to use various Toon Boom software.
And she's provided a YouTube link here so that...
I really advise checking it out if you haven't. She has an adorable little bird avatar.
There you are. Zuburbrain says, I really wanted to do this challenge, but had crazy week with Winterfest, Lackadaisy and all. So I took 3 hours of my Sunday night to do it. Not more. I feel amazing now and I'll go to sleep. I accomplished something, haven't animated in ages. Thank you for another great opportunity to animate on footage, which used to scare me, but I like more and more. Enjoy this weird shape-shifting thing, I don't know. Please disregard that lame excuse for a camera at the end. This amazing magic explosion drawing, lol. This was a late night quick add-on. I'm tired. Good night. You're wholesome and an amazing duo, and I wish you a wonderful day.
Aww, Zeb, that's really sweet. Oh my gosh. So yeah, Zeb has done hers in the 3 hours. So I'm excited to see what she's managed to accomplish in 3 hours. And also, thanks so much, Zeb, for taking your time to do this, even though you had such a busy week.
Yeah, thank you. Let's see.
Okay. She is a Toon Boom powerhouse, you're right. Let's have a look. Oh, it's a burb!
Does it work?
Love it, just becomes a ball at that point. Ooh! So cool. So this footage is slowed down, isn't it?
It looked like it could be, yeah.
The movement here is really fun. Like, I think you can tell that this is straight ahead. I like her reuse of frames is very, it's nice and clever. You know, the minimal frames needed for the run.
I think my favorite part is when it does that little arc. The bird does that little arc motion. It's got a really nice kind of like swoop to it.
Which arc motion? Because it does a couple of nice swoops.
Coming up here, that one. when it turns into like more particle stuff. Is that?
Ooh. Yeah, super cool. Let me see. Where can I give some feedback here? So you could have it. I have to like elbow my teamwork out of the way.
Any mods in the chat want to ban those bots? Because we don't want to become famous or buy followers.
How do you think we got all of these guys? Let's see. Hold to new sketch. That's what I want.
Thank you, pal, bro.
So I just think you could start the bird coming a little bit sooner. Not like I've done. Because you would have it appear much closer to where it was. Like this.
Thanks very much, Paula.
Because you want a nice curve on it, basically. Which I'm not giving you. Sorry about this. Can you turn up the music a little bit?
Turn it up.
I can enjoy it. Thank you. Appreciate it. There we go. Get rid of that dot. There we are. Okay. So it is a bit more of a convincing swoop now. A little bit more of a convincing swoop. Ah! He erased it by accident. There we go.
Stupid.
There we go. There we got a curve. There we go. That's more like spacing. Am I right?
Uh-huh. You cut me off.
Oh, I'm sorry.
As I said stupid, and then I'm like, I have to say that I was going to say stupid bots.
Oh,
no,
I'm
not talking about the animation.
No, I thought you were talking about me. I thought you were just like, stupid.
No.
I was like, okay, well, fair. Yeah, that's just me starting it a little bit earlier, just because it'd be nice to have it like really fade out of the sky. So,
also, like, prevents it from feeling like it just appears or like flickers into existence.
Yeah. So here, I feel like we're seeing a little bit of the underside of the bird, and I want to see more of that. So,
really? I was interpreting that as the beak down, but yeah, it's totally the other side of the wing.
I feel like it. That's what I feel like it is, because it's pulling up, isn't it?
Yeah, it totally is.
Which is why I want this curve to continue, like, here.
Yeah.
Look at this amazing picture of a bird I'm drawing. I know how to draw birds. Zeb, you're going to have to interpret this and make it into an actual bird.
You're adding aerodynamic.
What? yeah, that's what I'm doing.
With your S-curves.
I'm just trying to continue this nice motion that you set up, where we have the head pulling up. And we're getting to see like a bit more of the underside of the bird. Like that.
Logo. I think you overestimate the. Yeah. Are you talking about the.
You underestimate my power.
Yeah, we can make that available. Sure. What's the best way to distribute an image?
What, the logo?
Yeah.
The Animal Morning Challenge.
We can put it in a Google Drive, can't we?
Oh, yeah, that. We totally can. We can put it on a form if you guys want to use it or download it. Couldn't we? Could we put a link to a Google Drive file on the form?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Any one of those things, I think, yeah. Yeah, we can do that.
This bird going about town. According to this music. So yeah, I'm sorry about this bird shape, but my point is that we're getting to see a little bit more of its underbelly.
So that Francis guy on Twitter, we put a pin post and attached to the pin post underneath in a comment was the submission form for this week. At CERN, yeah, we post on Twitter and we also announce it on stream. So if you want to know...
You want to know? We can tell you! We can tell you on Mondays or Twitter!
Here's our link
Watch
tree.
The stream!
Shush. Here's our link tree where you can find our Twitter. A link to our Twitter.
Oh, read our tweet!
Oh, you don't have a Twitter? Yeah, you're out of luck then. We have nothing else. Do you have
yeah,
Instagram?
Then.
We could do an Instagram. I don't actually
do it. We don't have a Dog Swift Instagram.
No, we don't. We could, though.
We could, but I can't be asked.
Yeah.
We had not hard enough time just keeping up with the having more than one Twitter to take care of, so, you know. We can't be trusted with an Instagram account as well. You guys can't rely on
we
us.
We literally cannot be trusted.
We can't be trusted.
Yeah, we'll just post pictures of I don't know.
So this is what I'm we did it on the wrong frame. So this is what I'm thinking. Zeb, level with me here. This is what I'm thinking.
We had an embargo in posting pictures of Buffy, but that might have lifted. I'll have to ask Declan. Because it was like, it'd be weird for you to post pictures of my cat. I'm like, yeah, it probably would be. But we've lived here for a while now, so...
Well, I think one of the issues as well is that there's certain people that Declan doesn't want to see pictures of the cat.
Yeah, I think that might have lessened as well. Time heals all embargoes. And plus, you know, I've cleaned up her pee and her poo and her vomit. I think I've earned privileges. Where is she?
She's in the kitchen. I just fed her before the stream. So she's probably going to be scratching at the door at some point soon. But for now, she's just probably snuggled up asleep. Show underside of boob over next few frames. To pay off this nice twist that you've started here. Just play it out, essentially. Let it play. So we get to see a bit of the underside of the bird before it settles. Whee! Okay. Why is that on this frame? It shouldn't be.
What's your last piece of advice?
What? You've got to be kidding me. No. Come on. That can't be. I don't know how to use this program. There we are. That can't be the last piece of this can't. This. Wah!
And yeah, we've been streaming for an hour and you're on the second one. You got to pick your battles. Otherwise, no more Animorphing challenges. I'm putting my foot down.
You wouldn't.
I'm no sleep sassing you.
I would. This isn't advice. This is just me saying that you could do this, but it's not advice, so it doesn't count. You could have a little bit more of a curve going on here, with your spacing. It's just to have when it rounds this corner here. Just give it a few more frames to get to there.
Oh, it's certain saying that the Zebrabrain was using the tool on Toon Boom that autofills and closes the gap of her pen.
Oh, nice. Oh, I'd love to see that. I should go back and watch the stream of her doing this so I can learn how to do that myself. I have no clue how to do that myself, but it sounds super handy. Give it a few more frames to pull away. Fast and slow. Close. And far spacing. Nice contrast. So that, yeah, that wasn't advice. That was just me saying that. Okay. No, it wasn't. That was just me saying that you could do that if you wanted to, but you don't. I'm just looking at this. One sec.
Nice dissipation on the blues.
Yeah. Like, if this is meant to be here, the wing flapping again from the other side of the house, I feel like it feels like the bird would have to be, like, flying backwards slightly. For that, with the speed it's going, I'd expect it to disappear here and then not to reappear.
I would say also watch the volumes on those blue dissipating. It feels like they shrink and then grow a little bit and then shrink again. Yeah.
Then also this the black blob caught me unawares, but I really like this bit where it comes in here and swoops. Like, lovely swoop. Really, yeah, like this. Feels really nice. Very bird-like. Again, here I think you could really ease between these two positions to get into this swoop. I think that'd make it feel extra good. Like, add a few frames. Between this and previous position to get real nice ease. Real nice ease, TM. Because RNE is what it's all about. Super nice swoop, really nice lines of action. Love the way that the wings unfold here. Feel like you kind of want this shape to be a little bit longer here. And then maybe go off just here instead. Where is my tool? There it is. And then I think you want to give it just a couple of frames of being off screen before it comes back down through. This explosion, was this the one you were talking about? It's me.
Zed, please disregard that lame excuse for a canine run at the end after the amazing magic explosion drawing thing lol.
I really like this canine run, actually. I think it's real nice. You did a good job.
No critiques on the canine run.
Maybe just one. Maybe just when you push forward here to give the back more of a push. To give the back more of a what'd I call it? Have the back legs pushing the front legs higher up and forward more.
That's kind of line of action.
More like forward, this.
The force.
And then back to this. So it's treating the back a little bit more like a wave. So if you see that I'm trying to like convey here is you've got this kind of wave going on.
It's okay, no worries, Kimmy. We haven't gotten to yours yet. Let's do Kimmy's next.
Okay.
Hers is a dinosaur.
Okay. And I'll just put, think of it like a wave. Lovely run. Really fun stuff. See. Thank you so much for taking part. And also, can I just say, for 3 hours, this is real lot of work with flowers. Super fun. I guess that's the power of straight ahead. Really liking it. Super nice job, Z. All right, let's have a look at Kimmy's. Oh! The dinosaur! Look at him! I love him! Little arms! Oh my gosh.
Kimmy says, this was a lot of fun. I learned a little bit about dinosaur movement. It's kind of bird-like. I looked at Primal for reference for the run cycle, and I struggled a lot with leg placement and the jump. So, and felt like I needed more time to refine it. I would be very happy to know where I could improve.
I'll do my best. Though I may be stumped. Let's have a look. Oh, also, yeah, the Francis guy said this dinosaur gives me major Gendy Oh my god. Gendy Tarkovsky. I can't say his name.
Gendy Tarkovsky's primal vibes, yeah.
There we go. Thank you. I think he based it somewhat on that, right?
Yeah, that's what, yeah.
So yeah. And also, John, you can totally use 3D on this. If you can pin the footage to the camera so you can animate over it with a 3D rig, then go for it. 3D submissions are welcome. All right, let's have a look at this dinosaur. Oh, I love him. Look at them go. I like the way that they jump over the bushes. I also like that it makes them feel really small because they're running on the wall. This is like a tiny T-Rex.
Tiny dinosaur friend.
Tiny T-Rex. Oh my gosh. Okay, let's see. What can we do? Maybe we can do something with the jumps. I mean, this is tough. Because I think you might have to have them anticipate maybe even before this is on screen. Because at the minute it feels like they're not quite clearing it. Because it feels like they're kind of jumping. It feels like the foot is still planted on the ground here. Where the bush is. I wonder if we could have it like lead with the head a little bit more.
I will call that you're the way that you were like bushes.
Bushes. Let me pop on this. Oh ho ho. So.
How would you anticipate?
There's a nice back curve here that I think we could probably take advantage of going on this run position. So we could dip the head a little bit earlier if we follow the back position. Be aware that your T-Rex is about to turn into a seal because I'm not very very well versed on drawing T-Rexes. So my solution's going to be to essentially join them together in one fluid shape like a seal. So your dinosaur may end up looking slightly more like that.
That's fine. Short hands. Let's do it.
Yeah, pretty much.
Down in preparation for up.
Yeah. Head's going down first. It's going to lead with its head because we said so. And no one can stop us. Let's put that back leg down sooner. And that's going to be our jumping off point. This dinosaur is going to use this as its jumping off point. So, it's getting down, it's getting low. Shorty getting low. In preparation for this jump. Cause it's gonna pull all that mass of its butt and body with its head. Cause that sounds like a good plan. Getting that weight coming down. And the stream theme has come on, as it should have. Okay. So, looking at the distance from here to here is what I'm going to keep when it comes to its contact position. So, I want its contact position to stay here. And it's okay to me if the dinosaur lags behind a little bit during the anticipation, because it's just gathering its weight and strength and preparing to lift off like an aeroplane.
So you give it a little bit of slowdown so that when it pushes off, it catches up with the camera.
Yeah, it's going to spring forward.
That's clever. I like that.
Thank you. I don't feel like it's all too clever, but I appreciate it. And I'm going to just bunch it all up together now, like a concertina. It's like... neck folds.
Bulge.
Don't you talk about this dinosaur's bulge. You leave this dinosaur alone.
I'm not the one that's drawing it like that. I love your comedic shorthand. Chungus Dino, yeah. Jump.
It's getting ready. It's preparation. I did its arm a bit too small, but that's where its arm would be. Where would its front leg be? It's a mystery.
I think it would probably like... I mean... It probably...
Because
like,
this is like its back leg.
It probably comes to kind of meet where its back leg is.
Yeah, it's probably just going to be like this kind of thing. And then are we ready for the burst forward? I don't know what's going to happen, guys. I don't know what's going to happen. Okay. So we're going to take it off from this position because, again, I'm tracking the distance between where the moss starts and where its foot's
feet
planted.
Yeah.
So it's launching itself now. Dinosaur is becoming airborne. It's one thing I didn't think I'd be doodling today. It would be a T-Rex taking off. So thank you for this, Kimmy. I appreciate it. I hope we can find something that that works and helps and improves rather than this just being ridiculous. Okay, so I'm going to snap that tail down and push it forward. Come on, T-Rex! Come on, T-Rex, you can do it! You got this!
Wait.
What?
Have the head slightly lower. Because he'll probably... I feel like if it's kicking from the leg, it's gonna go up through, like, the torso first, and the head's gonna drag a little bit more.
You want the head to drag?
Yeah.
Poor T-Rex! This T-Rex is going to look ridiculous if you have me drag the head. More so than it already does. Let's see if... We'll try it without, and then if it feels like it needs the head drag, we'll add that on. Hold on, I need to make it look determined. Yeah! T-Rex going!
Okay.
T-Rex ascend! Okay, yeah, so now it's gonna use its momentum. It's gonna. Its foot's gonna come forward. its tiny arms are going to drag backwards. And like some kind of graceful whale, it's going to take off into the sky. Here we go. Here it goes. Oh! It's going. It's going. Huh. Oh! Never thought you'd see a dinosaur fly, but here it is. It's flying. It's become not a T-Rex anymore.
Yeah.
I don't know what it is now. Some kind of silverfish.
You've just turned it into googly lizard.
Okay, wait. Wait, though, because it's going to become more like a T-Rex again in a second. I swear, I'm going to bring it back. Bring back that square head.
Barbasaur, nice. I love that.
Oh my gosh, my chicken scratch is so chicken scratch. I'm really sorry, Kimmy. Hope that this is legible.
You're watching the Animation Breakfast Club with Doug and Swift. We hope you enjoy your time. I could be.
Yeah, you could be an ad guy. Would you be our ad guy?
Yeah. If you ever want me to do ads, I'll do ads.
I'm just trying to figure out where this back leg would be.
Barbasaur, your children's favorite cereal.
I mean, I feel like one of the problems is that Kimmy is animating a T-Rex that's pretty realistic. And I don't think my chonky T-Rex is very realistic.
You're adding a bit more exaggeration.
That's definitely one way to put it.
Did that ad break wake you all up? Did it break the sort of more chill flow? That was my intention.
Like, I feel like if Kimmy's looking to animate a more realistic T-Rex, maybe my feedback isn't going to be super helpful right now. Since my feedback is turn it into a Looney Tunes character, essentially. I don't think T-Rexed would actually jump like this.
I think you're missing the really important pelvic bone on a T-Rex.
Yeah? How does that work?
Oh, it looks like a big pendulum, but I think it it's encompassed within the mat.
I think.
Also, apparently T-Rexes had big old plumy feathers on their neck.
Oh yeah, that's cool. Here it goes. And then it's going to prepare for landing, I guess. It's got to extend that leg. Pretty much like Kimmy has it doing. Yeah. I like how both of our T-Rexes at this point in the animation have become as birds. Yeah, I feel like here tail needs to start coming up so that when we get to this point it can be trying to counterbalance this. You know, it's great that this is a job that we can do.
Well, animating.
Animating a T-Rex.
Ah.
Best job in the world. Animation, right? The greatest.
Animation's really powerful. I think.
What you said for a second, animation's really horrible. I was like, how dare you?
No, powerful. As a storytelling vehicle, it's to me, it's unparalleled.
Yes, I believe so too. Because I think it's the filmmaking process in which you have the most control over every part of the process. Because every single frame is crafted.
I feel like animation can take a lot of influence from other mediums as well. I want to see it kind of... Well, you see it outside of, you know, the Western Hollywood stuff. You see a lot of cool experimental animation from, you know, Europe, and you've got the kind of any genre that you want over in, like, Japanese animation. I just feel like...
Oh, genre-wise, you don't want it to be put in a box anymore.
I just, like, if I could get a t-shirt, it would be like, animation isn't for kids. Animation is for everybody.
Yeah, I mean, it is for kids. But it's also for a bunch of other people. You know, I'd have a t-shirt saying animation is for kids and adults and babies and the elderly.
I don't know. Like, I think if you said animation isn't for kids, it'd be like, what do you mean? And you're like, Whereas if you're like, animation is for kids, people might stop reading. You gotta be sensationalist with your t-shirt slogans.
I don't know if you do. Like, I feel like you catch more flies with honey than you do with sticks.
That's blatantly not true.
What do you mean?
Well, clickbait wouldn't work if you catch more people with honey.
Well, the point with the clickbait is that it kind of it tells people something they want to know. Either something they want to know and are curious about, or something that it confirms what they already think they know.
So
if you're telling people
bias,
they're wrong, they're less likely to want to click it. You know, you don't have a clickbait where it's like, learn why you're a terrible person, because no one would click it. You have clickbait where it's like, learn how to get the hottest, coolest person to give you all the money, and also a holiday and car and sex and Bitcoin.
I heard that as holiday in car sex.
Holiday in car sex. That sounds awful. Holiday Inn's the classiest place. Okay.
I guess.
I think if you're like, animation's not for kids, you're gonna have a bunch of people going,
yes,
like,
is.
Not reading the rest of it and being like, what are you talking about? How could you say that? My kids love animation.
I like that. I like that Wanks is sort of like, did any of you just say sex? ?
Sex fish.
This is a Christian Minecraft server.
Okay, so I think we could get a little bit more weight on the landing here. I think that's my fault. Like, you totally want a little bit of an ease going on here when it's in the air, getting into this position. And then when it gets down here, you really want it to, like, do a little settle for a few frames before it continues running, just to, like, get the weight of it. Like, this might be the part where you want to drag the head a little bit. And then it's like, I'm back. Been away for a bit. And then it's like back to normal, basically.
No, I would say more like animation is marketed predominantly for kids and their parents. But like a film like The Avengers, that's just a live action cartoon. Sort of. I'm mixing my message here. I'm tired. So.
Can't believe you'd say that. How could you say something so controversial and yet so brave? I definitely feel like there should be more genres open to animation, and I think animation is free to take more influence from film than it currently does. And I also agree with you that I feel like animation from Japan and elsewhere.
Embraces that as...
Yeah, it does embrace storytelling.
They view animation as a medium for their storytelling rather than as a genre for a particular kind of story.
Yeah, exactly. And I think that people in the Western world can learn a lot.
You see, I saw a comment where someone was like, I don't like this style of music, but I like this song. And I'm just thinking, then you like that style of music because you like that song. Like, people have this thing of like, I don't want to admit to liking this big group if I like this particular part of it. And it's like, just all that matters is what you do like. Don't get hung up on being perceived for liking something that you don't want to be perceived to like just because something, I don't know.
I think what you're feeling there is that people want to say, I like Westerns, but then they'll see a Western they don't like, or they'll see something which isn't a Western that they like, and they'll be like, but this isn't a Western! How, my entire sense of self!
Yeah, people get caught up on genre and grouping and for the world to make sense.
Well, isn't that just a human condition? Is people trying to fit other things into groups and boxes that don't belong in groups and boxes?
Yeah.
Trying to label things as being certain things. Okay. What I'm trying to get across here is just like to give the landing at the end a little bit more time to settle so that we feel that weight. I feel like we need like a little bit more smoothing here, where I've held it for 3 frames there. 1, 2, 3, 4. I've held it for 4 frames there, and we probably just need that bit on 2s. And you don't have to go as cartoony as I've gone, but I think a little bit of influence from this wouldn't hurt. Although obviously you don't have to take it out of verbatim, because I know that it's like way more cartoony than you were probably going for. It would probably hang back a little bit here. Looking at the foot placement, like it's going to plant its foot and land here, and then that foot is going to probably be glued to the ground until it takes off again about here. Back into the run. I'd also love to see you do 2 separate jumps for the 2 different bits of plant, because at the minute I think it's the same jump repeated. I'd love to see just a slight bit of variation.
It's not the same jump.
Is it not?
Take your notes off and scrub through it. Which foot is the right foot is leading on that jump.
Let's have a look.
The foreground foot.
Yeah.
On that one. And what's the next one? Foreground foot. I'm wrong.
Yeah, I think it's the same frames.
I'm wrong.
I like the nice curve you got on the tail going on, like nice little motion there. I think the last thing I'd say is maybe it feels like the head jabs forward a bit too suddenly. I'd make that a smoother thing. Have that circular motion of the head feel a bit smoother. And maybe offset it to the body a little bit too.
So by offset you mean,
so think
body
about
lands than head.
Yeah. Think of it kind of like a chicken.
Okay.
Like, you know how a chicken tries to keep its head constant?
Yeah.
Like body go up, head go down?
Yeah.
Kind of like that. Except you would give the head like a little bit of motion because the head's super heavy. It's not like a chicken which has hollow bones and is super lightweight. But you would think about the body and the head in the same way, kind of like a wave shape. So if you're thinking about like body and then head and then tail, and you would have like these kind of shapes happening, you know.
or like this kind of shape happening. That makes sense?
Yeah.
Think about it kind of like that. And of course, watching Jurassic Park like a million times because that movie's really fun. I still haven't watched Primal and I really need to.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, I do.
I haven't seen it yet, but I also want to see it.
Nice job, Kimmy. This is awesome. Thank you so much for doing a dinosaur as well. I love dinosaurs.
Bonus point.
Yeah, bonus points for dinosaur.
Who's up next?
Should I go to the second one?
Sure.
Okay.
Jeff Koe.
Jeff Koe.
I think Jeff might work at Saloon as well.
Oh!
Kimmy, do you know Jeff?
That's awesome.
I might be wrong. I have a vague... You know when you like see a name, you're like, fact? I'm not sure, but... Yeah, oh cool, it's a Jeff. Awesome. Let's do it.
Okay, let's do it. Oh, look! Oh my gosh! The way it crashes into the house at the end, I wasn't expecting that. That's awesome. So wait, how did you do those? They're just drawings, but because of the color of them,
The color matching, lighting, yeah.
Matching so well with the roof, I was like, are those actual bricks? What? Got me really fooled. Cool. Got me fooled, yo. Look at this. This is beautiful.
I love the use of the slope.
Dude, I don't know if I'm going to be able to find anything to feedback on this.
That's okay. Like,
we can just appreciate it. We can just go through and be like, look how beautiful this is. I guess one thing I could potentially call out. Look at this lovely posing. He's like, ah, no! Although it does kind of make sense. Is that it really seems to shrink between this frame and this frame. It feels like there's a little bit of shrinkage going on, but then again, that background house is a little bit further from the camera. So it could be going back into space, but the perspective on it makes it look like it's jumping straight across.
Yeah, I think it loses just a little bit of volume.
Yeah. So I'd either keep it the same size or maybe adjust these poses here on the takeoff so that we feel more like it's jumping. It's time for me to draw an arrow. Jumping slightly in this direction. Rather than straight. Look at this nitpicking I'm having to do. Ridiculous. I can't believe you'd make me nitpick like this. Which reminds me.
Yeah.
Talking of nitpicking, would you guys like us to do another TMNT animation analysis stream? This time on the animation rather than the boards.
Heck yeah. So
that'd be something you guys would be interested in.
The VODs, the videos on YouTube got taken down by Viacom, so we need to figure out a way to...
Oh, they did?
Yeah.
Viacom?
Yeah, we need to figure out a way to do it without that happening.
Viacom, we're trying to help more people see it.
Fucking
you dinguses! You doofs!
Yeah, so I still have to appeal those.
You know, I should put this on the same frame. So, losing a little bit of volume in this jump, just a little bit. A little bit of volume in this jump.
I mean, the clip that we showed that they were like, no, is the one that they put out on the one that got like all the views on Twitter, that like I think they also put on their like TMNT channels and stuff. Anyway, I'm gonna compete with it, but not compete, appeal on the grounds of it's
educational. Yeah, it definitely falls under the use of under the fair use category, because we're analysing the work for educational means.
Yeah.
Or just posing here. So jump.
Oh, Righteous Bison. Is that you, Jeff?
Oh, hey!
You haven't missed too much, aside from us just watching it and gushing.
Yeah, geez, Jeff, what am I meant to do with this? You fucking come in here with an amazing animation and expect me to be able to do any kind of feedback on it, and I'm just like, nope, it's beautiful. Can't think of anything. This is gorgeous. Really, really nice work, dude. Look at these fun poses.
I like that.
Wah!
There's a feeling of a little bit of a scrabble for it to try and get up that side of the roof.
It's, yeah, the posing is beautiful on this. You could add like a few tiny touches of leaves and stuff being scattered to make it feel extra like it's part of the background, but that's like the animation on the animal itself. I think it's a bison. But correct me if I'm wrong.
Yeah.
I can't fault it, dude. It's beautiful. Like, I just love watching it. I just want to learn from it.
Oh, sorry about that. I gave people an extra week because I announced it so late. You thought it was for last week.
Oh, we're so sorry. I'm sorry you didn't. You worked overtime to finish it. It's gorgeous, but I'm sorry that you had to really crunch to get it done. You did a beautiful job of it. Oh, you've even got shingles. I was gonna say you could put some shingles being scattered off this roof here, and you've done it.
How can we make it up to you, Jeff?
What can we do? Because we definitely can't give you like much helpful feedback on this, because it's great. Even bouncing. These shingles are bouncing.
That back sky really doesn't move. I'm just watching the parallax of a live action shot, and it's just like, the sky's just like, yep.
Yeah.
Huge.
Mm-hmm. The further away something really is, the less it's going to move. How gorgeous this guy's. I guess I'm wondering if like it'd be nice to have a little bit more hang time in the air here before it falls into the house, but I don't know. All on once as well. It's gorgeous. Let me just take off the feedback. Yeah, it's just something I want to look at for hours and just learn from, dude. It's gorgeous. All the arcs are so nice. Mm. Like, all the poses are so clear. Look at the way that the back goes into the tail and into that top shape of, like, the shoulder hump. Everything's, like, really nicely simplified. The drag that's going on with the fur on both the bottom of the head and, like, the fringe. You can track the head rotation really nicely through the horns. A really nice appealing design too, just in terms of having this big bulky body and then these kind of skinny legs. Yeah. I don't know whether maybe I feel like there should be more resistance when it meets this this house. There's something in it jumping into the house at the end here that feels maybe a little bit fast.
Like if it had...
Like if it almost did like a false landing where its head comes up on this frame because it thinks it's landed. But its feet are continuing to push downwards through the house. So you kind of have this kind of thing going on.
Jeff is saying, I found the timing all quite tricky while on ones. I thought maybe I shouldn't have done it that way, but I really wanted to see it matching with the cam.
Yeah, I think it looks beautiful on ones, dude. I think you did an amazing job with that.
If the bison can like run across the other roofs, then this particular house needs more repair.
Maybe it's my parents' house. Like, my dad's been too busy DIYing it.
The bathroom wall's missing.
Yeah.
Replaced by bison.
We don't have a wall anymore, now we have bison.
And there's 63 people!
63 Hello. People! Hey people! All you beautiful
yourself.
People, looking good!
You're watching.
Love what you're wearing today.
Animation Breakfast Club. If you're not following us on other various socials, here's our links.
Then don't, it's terrible.
Do
yeah, it's terrible. We never update or do anything. So there's no point.
A Twitter and a we have a Patreon and stuff on it. If you like this sort of stuff, you're quite quiet again. I'm just talking really, really quietly.
Dude, project.
Check out our Patreon on the Linktree. How about that?
Linktree.
Yeah, I've made us a Linktree, India.
I don't know what that is.
It's a site where it has all of our social links. All laid out all night. And it's all in one place. It's easy to link to them all. It's useful.
Like maybe this, like maybe just having the head throw back a little bit when it lands. Like it's expecting to land properly and then that doesn't happen. You have to excuse it being on twos.
Oh no.
Who knew? What happened? Who knew? Oh sorry, I got a sneeze coming. Achoo! Achoo!
Okay, we good. Pikachu.
We good.
I choose you, Pikachu.
No, you know what, Jeff? I just played that through and that kind of looks ridiculous. It makes me laugh. Probably not what you're going for.
Have you cartoonified?
It's just like this poor bison.
Is that its mouth?
No, it's fringe. It's meant to be its fringe.
Okay, because it kind of looks like the head is like.
I should use the landmarks that are so nicely thought up for me instead. Yeah. But yeah, I don't think this has really helped. I think it looks kind of ridiculous to have his head thrown back like that. I wonder if we just do it for one frame, what would happen then? Then what? Let's find out. Nah, it's too subtle, I think. On ones, it's too hard. You might have to have it like anticipating here. If you're gonna do it. I think maybe it's just good the way it is. You know? Maybe this isn't one that I can help out too much with.
Thank you very much for submitting, Jeff.
Oh yeah, that's not so bad. This here. But it's very subjective, so it's completely up to you. This is beautiful as it is. My only real piece of feedback was the one I went on. I don't know if you're on the stream when I said it, but just this jump here, because of the position and the poses of the bison, it looks like it's jumping straight across, but the house is like a little bit far back and there's a little bit of shrinkage on the bison, so I can't tell if it's just losing a little bit of volume here and you want it to be jumping straight across, or if you're losing volume because you're having it jump into the distance but the poses just aren't matching that direction change is happening. So I'd either maintain the volume during this jump a little bit more, like keep it a little bit bigger so that it feels like it's jumping straight across, or keep the sizing you have but just adjust these poses so it feels like it's jumping slightly more three quarters into the background, just slightly. That's it. It's the only feedback I have for you, dude. Like, I think you did an incredible job.
Robin, what do you need three people for?
Absolutely beautiful. I can't spell beautiful. Beautiful. Beauty. Gosh darn. There we go. Beautiful. Adam Goals. Beautiful. Oh, that's bleeding beautiful, that is.
Oh, for the haha number. Okay.
Now, we only have 5 minutes left on the stream. I don't know whether that's enough time to do a proper critique. Do you think we should leave the rest to tomorrow? Or should I try and... I don't want to try and cram one into 5 minutes.
How many do we have left?
I feel like people deserve better than that. We have 6. But I'll be faster tomorrow, I promise.
Abu says, India, see my Mikey, please. I just want you to see it.
Okay, sure thing. Let's have a look at my mics. Let's have a look at Habbo's. Where are you, Habbo? There you are.
Habbo's, I think, has music to it.
Have you animated Michael Doig? Oh, it has music.
Yes.
Yeah, I can't.
So you might need headphones.
Hold on, I think it's doing something. There's a green bar going across this. It doesn't have a waveform on it.
Oh.
So I don't know if it...
Maybe...
Ooh, fisheye! This is going to be fun.
Can you hear it?
Let me put my headphones on and give it a scrub.
Can you hear it at home? At stream?
Yes, it's Michael Doig. Oh my gosh. Michael parkouring across.
If there's no sound, then don't watch it.
If there's no sound, then don't watch it.
Then maybe you can bring it up on Twitter and watch it with the sound.
Okay. Sure thing.
How about link it?
Oh yeah, that'd be easiest.
Or whisper it or something.
I wonder why it didn't come in with sound. That's weird.
Yeah, there should be music right from the beginning.
Habbo! Oh! I can find it if you... Oh, thanks. That was super fast. Okay. Have a look. Whoop, let me... Oh, there is sound. Can you guys hear it? Or do I need to send it?
You might have to choose to send it.
Okay, one sec. Need to remember how to do this. Here we go. Audio source. System audio. Are you guys hearing that?
They're saying they can hear it, yeah.
Awesome! How's this? Are you impressed at the size of my window? Okay, here we go. Yo. These are some sick beats. What?
Pause it. I need you to stop the other music from playing.
Oh my gosh, it's Sunflower!
Okay.
Right? Da 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 da. Take me back to Spider-Verse. Okay, here we go. Let's do it. Oh my gosh! It's my TMNT Mikey! Oh my gosh, this is adorable, Habbo. Oh, I love it! Look at him go! I love the fisheye camera, that's really fun. I love seeing you play a perspective like this. seeing all the planning lines going across it. Are you planning to finish this anymore? This is so fun. I love it. Oh my gosh, I'd love to see this, like, get to the tie down stage. No cleanup, because who needs that? Kimmy's like, I need it. Look at this, so cool. It's really cool to see you mapping out the perspective here. This is really awesome. Oh, nice outfit. Heck yeah. Want to see some more shots of that sweet outfit? It's going to be so fun. Yeah!
That's awesome, Habbo.
Just having fun skating down the railway line. Yeah, this is awesome. Aw, man.
Really good job in, like, getting that perspective to feel cohesive.
Yeah! It's so cute.
Wait, it's cutting off. You had to full screen it.
I can unfull screen it if you want.
Fine. Good.
Fine. His face in this one frame is like, blip. Yeah, he's doing a blip. I'm going to find the blip again. Where are you? So cute. It looks like it was a lot of fun. This is a challenge that I really want to do myself. Like, obviously I won't be able to do it for this week, but I'd like to just do it anyway.
With this footage?
With some footage. I really like the idea of doing it with fisheye. I think this was an awesome idea. How about, because it really challenges your perspective.
Was the whole footage fisheye, but we just couldn't tell because... Or did it move?
What?
Or did... How about, did you find your own reference?
This is different to ours.
Okay.
I think. This is inside a subway tunnel, looks like.
You grabbed another footage. Fair enough.
Yeah. Yeah. Herm. So fun. Oh, this is a nice way to end the stream. Man, if I saw this while I was in a train car, I'd be like, F yeah.
Hey, let me off.
I want to join in.
Yeah,
like one time we were in Dublin city centre on a tram and it was a dude dressed as Sonic running next to the tram.
Oh yeah.
And I was like, let me out.
Wasn't he like trying to race the tram from one station to the next or something?
I was like, let me out. I want to run with him.
Run with him.
He's got everything I need. I don't know if that dude does it regularly, but I feel like a couple of people have mentioned him. This is gorgeous, Habbo.
Okay, so we went through all.
Oh my gosh! Yeah. Just gonna like everyone's comment.
No? Yeah, Anima Tunings. If you want to follow Habbo, he's Anima Tunings. Let me find the link.
Okay, you are.
I've not been liking everyone else because I've simply forgotten. I'm sorry, but.
There are too many comments. There we go.
When Twitter is literally in my face, then I remember.
What's the next challenge? Oh yeah, I need to tell you guys what the next challenge is. So this week we're gonna do something a little bit different.
This is Kimmy's.
Because I've got the power to do that.
And Jeff didn't give me theirs, so there's everyone's links. We'll follow all the cool animators. And let me refix the...
Okay. I'm just checking something online, guys.
Checking.
Nice. Okay, so this week's challenge, we're gonna do a character design challenge.
What?
Because I know that a lot of the people who enjoy drawing and animating also enjoy designing a lot.
Okay.
So I thought it'd be a lot of fun to design a character for animation. And we can really think about, like, how to design a simple, like, clean design that's going to be easy to move, but also really, really deliver on visually showing who that character is.
Okay.
And what they do. So.
So, what's the...
What I don't have ready for today is the actual prompt on what the character is going to be.
All right.
So maybe that's going to be something where we can be like, we'll tweet it out later today.
Okay.
Because I want everyone to work from the same prompt, because I think one of the fun things will be seeing how different people tackle the same concept.
So this isn't bring your previously designed character.
No, this is design something specifically based on a prompt that we give you, but design it with animation in mind.
Okay. Are you thinking like... prompt could be around a function or around a theme?
I need to work that out, okay. Basically. But I think along with the prompt itself, we'll link like you guys a bunch of resources on character design stuff.
That's cool. Yeah.
Yeah. Because I'd be really interested to see if we give people... if we give people some information about a character and what they need to do and what their function would be in the story, to see how people would draw that, how different people would draw that, I think will be really cool and interesting.
I think that's really awesome.
Or maybe we could give people a couple to pick from. So there's a little bit of variety in there. So we could put out three prompts and people could choose which one appeals to them the most.
Whatever you feel is good.
Yeah. But I remember way back when we first started streaming and we first started the Discord, I remember we were doing Hollow Knight Let's Play. And I remember one of the first challenges we did as a group of artists was to design Hollow Knight personas.
Oh, yeah.
And how much fun everyone had doing that. So I want to do something like that again, where we're all designing together.
Yeah. That's really cool. Like
yeah.
If it was people designing their own piggy. I'm kidding, but...
I mean, it could be something like that. We could do a pirate pig. Or something, see what people do. But yeah. Yeah, we'll give you the prompt properly when I have a little bit of time to think on it. Probably today or at latest tomorrow. And link you guys to it. I also want to talk a little bit about character design this week, just to give you guys like my approach on it in case it helps anyone out.
I think that'd be really cool.
Because it's something that I feel strongly about.
You've written various like posts and stuff specifically about character design in the past.
Yeah, and I think that's something that we could link. But like, I want to look at a few successful character designs as well, and break down what I think makes them so good.
Okay.
And just talk about like the philosophy behind it.
I think then.
And then I think once we've designed those characters, it makes sense that the challenge after that we'll probably use them for something, and really test out how easy they are to animate based on what you've designed.
I think that's a really cool idea.
Yes.
Or maybe like we can sort of figure out what ones were the successful ones, and then those would become the model sheet for another challenge or something like that.
Maybe. We definitely should do one of these days where we have a model sheet that people try to use.
Yeah. I don't want to make the challenge too competitive, but I do want to make it like collaborative and have a little bit of a kind of like...
That's why I think a little bit of choice is probably good. That not everyone is doing exactly the same thing. You have a bit of choice on...
Yeah.
What feels best to you?
Maybe it could be like an ensemble, a group that needs to kind of fit together or something.
Yeah.
Like Sonic Heroes style.
How much time for this challenge? I'd say again, 3 hours. 3 hours is how much we would expect you to spend on it. You're welcome to spend more on it if you want to. You're also welcome to spend less on it if you want to. The 3 hours is there as a kind of marker to encourage you guys not to have to like kill yourselves to get this completed.
Yeah.
You know, we want to make sure that you guys still have time for personal projects and those still take precedent over this.
Like this kind of takes on the structure of homework in a way.
It's more like little skill exercises that you can do.
Yeah. And you know? Like you can apply yourself. Like if you're wanting to put work into a portfolio piece and you want to theme it around whatever we're giving, then
you could expand.
You're welcome to spend more than 3 hours. 3 hours is just more like this will give you a rough the benefits of the lesson if you apply yourself for about this long.
Yeah. I think so. It'll give you the basis. Especially when it comes to animation, we're not expecting anything like clean.
No.
Or even tied down, like roughs. Roughs are definitely where it's at.
So that's when the animation occurs.
So it'll be to this next coming Monday. So this next one coming, Palbro. So this will be a 1 week challenge, not a 2 week challenge.
Cool. I was hoping to maybe show them I would do a little bit of piggy work this morning. How would you feel about me continuing the stream doing some piggy stuff?
I need to get on with stuff, so it might not be the best day for it. Because okay. I'm going to be listening to audio and such and getting some revisions finished.
Alrighty.
I'm sorry.
That's okay. Just putting the question out there. sure. Okay, let's find someone to raid then.
Alright. And yeah, Hinkabink will do this on stream through the week. So tomorrow we'll finish off looking at these Anna Morning challenges. And then probably Wednesday, I'll do a little rundown of my process of character design in case anyone is interested or it's helpful to anyone. But we'll put up the challenge in full on Twitter either today or tomorrow, latest. And we'll get our design on.
We're just looking for who's online. Patrick Rothfuss is playing Minecraft.
My gosh, Patrick.
Can we raid Patrick Rothfuss?
Yeah, we can raid Patrick Rothfuss if you want.
Okay, cool. I've just been reading his book.
So for anyone who doesn't know who Patrick Rothfuss is, do you wanna explain to people?
He's an author. He's written a number of books in the King Killer Chronicles series. So Name of the Wind, Wise Man's Fear, and I think the next one is Doors of Stone. And he's just really fun and engaging. You might have seen him on things like, I think he's been on Critical Role. He's been on, he's a great D&D player. He
plays with the Penny Arcade guys a lot, so you've probably seen him on PAX.
Yeah. I have no idea if he's actually playing Minecraft or not, but let's click on him.
Yeah, Mike and I love his books.
Yeah, Name of the Wind guy. He streams on Twitch and he's playing Minecraft. Or at least he says he's playing Minecraft. Whenever
he knows what he's actually doing.
Into one of his streams, it's always like he's talking for most of it. He is playing bonus charity stream, Pat Drunk speedruns Minecraft, also prizes for charity.
Pat Drunk speedruns Minecraft. And alright,
he's been streaming for about 2 hours. We gotta do this. Please tell Pat to have a great adventure.
Yeah. That's a nice thing to say.
Yeah.
Have okay. a great adventure. Raid!
Starting the raid. Oh, I'm excited. I'm gonna...
You're gonna hop in there, Mike, and... Oh. Yeah!
I love his books. I've been, like, reading Name of the Wind and just opening a random page and just reading from there, and it's always so engaging.
Welcome to my bathroom experience.
I figured that's what you were doing.
Yeah.
I recently reread the entirety of both in the hopes that...
That by the time you finished.
Yeah. no such luck, but it's fine.
Thank you guys so much for submitting some challenges this week. It's been really cool to look at them. I can't wait to see more tomorrow. You guys rock.
Yeah, we'll be looking at those tomorrow. Thank you so much for coming by.
And may the rest
of your day
be filled
with
adventure.
Take care. Thank you for all the raids and the subs and the love and the hugs.
Yeah,
and the
thanks,
cheers.
Guys.
We'll
love
be back
you.
Tomorrow. Adventure.
Adventure.
He must say yes. Make him say yes.